Good afternoon and welcome to the Basketball Ireland Schools League final between Cloche na Corrib and St. Mary's College Dundalk. I'm here with Martin Conroy from ITC Basketball. Hello Martin, how are you keeping?
How are you doing, JP? Looking forward to a good game here.
Yeah, it should be a great game.
Cloche na Corrib were beaten in the, or did they win the cup final, I think?
They did win the cup final, the under-16B cup final there not so long ago.
It was Thomas Rice there with the first basket for St. Mary's. Another three comes up, and a great score from number six, and that's
Cronin McWard. He was earmarked before the game to me that he'd be their star man today, so hopefully he comes up trumps for the name. Nice little pass inside there. Good steal by McWard there. Long pass. McConnell passes it out. Out to McWard again, just misses there.
Gormley draws a foul. First foul is going to be on Thomas Rice. He hit the first shot for St. Mary's. McWard again. It was O'Gormla with the missed three, and the rebound comes to St. Mary's. Abagon. Hand off to Markey. Nice score for Markey. I wonder, is that Brendan Markey's son, the referee from up in Dundalk?
If he gets some good calls today, we'll know all about it.
Good block for Markey.
Pepito has some energy about him anyway.
Good strong move inside. Rebound taken by Okuba. Nice pass, O'Gormla.
O'Gormla gets the easy layup.
Did well, went to the other side of the basket, stopped the defender getting his hand on it.
So it's five apiece with 5.5 minutes left in the first quarter.
They've settled in pretty well. Nice pass from McWard there.
Seen a bit of long passing already in the game.
Yeah, it's a good start. Like 2 minutes in, they're both on 5 points. They're not afraid to take the shot. One team playing man, another team playing zone.
Out to Gormley. Just misses. Another rebound there by Okubu. Okuba, sorry.
Fapito. Abagon misses the shot. Fabito, great job on the boards. Unfortunately, it's going to come out to Connolly. Great drive from McWard there. He took the hit as he was going to the basket. Knew exactly what he was doing. Going to go to the line for two free throws. Third team foul already on St. Mary's Dundalk. This is both great rebound.
Lovely there by Connolly.
Connolly, yeah, good finish from him. Abagon stepped out there. Referee Stephen Brearley wants to have a chat with him. Didn't like the way he threw away the ball there, JP.
No.
Great official, Stephen. He's been around for a long time.
Nice pass. Stevens out to
Madden. He's back Ward again.
Unlucky there by Madden. Some good play there from him. Bit of energy.
And they're moving the ball well. They just settled for a couple of outside shots. Maybe, you know, a bit more penetration will get them easier scores against that zone. They're not going to get the outside shot all the time. Going to try and force Dundalk to come out of their zone a little bit.
Pepita. Wow. Goes coast to coast with that one.
Great score from Pepito. Nice soft finish off the glass. McWard, that's what I'm talking about, that drive. There you go.
Oh.
He's going to get an end line possession off that.
Cormley takes a shot, just misses.
Abigon with the rebound.
Pulls with Pepito.
Great pass.
Lovely vision there.
Great pass from Pepito. And a nice finish from Rice for his fourth point of the game. Now they seem to be settling to allow the outside shot to come from Kolosha Nakarova. Abigon has the ball stolen away from him. And does a good job of getting it back for his team.
So they're not putting too much pressure on the three-point shooter there, Martin.
No, they seem to be allowing the outside shot and hopefully clean up the rebounds. You know, it's when the drive comes, it's going to pull them out of position a little bit. It's going to make the maybe an easier two. There's a good pass inside from Rice.
They definitely have the height difference inside St. Mary's.
Super drive by Connolly, I think, by Gormley.
And Turley has the ball now. Oh, great steal by Pepito. See, you can finish it. Oh.
Great job. See the way he used his body. You know, drew the foul very well. Going to go to the line for two free throws now. Looks like a good kid, this kid.
Just missed the first one.
Again, as we said in the last game, it's a hard place to shoot free throws. There you
Lovely.
Go. A lot better. Gives this team a 3-point lead, 10 points to 7 with 3:02 to go in the first.
We're back here with 3 minutes left on the clock in the first quarter. It's Kolosha Nakarov, 7 points. St. Mary's Drogheda, 10 points. Some nice passing there. Just missed out on the 3-point there with McWard.
He hit his first one. He's missed two open shots since then.
Travel there called on Madden.
Again, that zone defense is working well for Mary's at the moment, holding the opposition to 7 points. Markey. Rice pulls up for the shot, misses it. Rebound by Markey. Great score.
That's nice.
Great score by Luke Markey. Nearly an interception, but good drive to the basket from number 15, Martino Connolly. He's going to go to the line for a free throw, an extra bonus.
Unlucky.
Ball came off blue, so it's going to be a flush in the carrot ball.
Out to Madden. Pass it to Gormley. Gormley passes it out to McWard. He has to think about it. He goes inside.
Nice spin. Just didn't get the finish on it.
Rice with the ball inside to Akuba.
Great rebound again there by Akuba. As Rice puts up the next shot. McWard sees the floor really well. Great pass out. Nice hesitation. Nice score coming in from number 7. That's Oisin O'Gormley.
Back to a one-point game now. 1.5 minutes left on the clock. Fabito with the ball.
Dundalk need to get a basket. Haven't scored in a little while now. And here's Luke Markey with a big three.
Good rebound in there. The Connolly, is it?
It is indeed. Gormley. Switches it out to Connolly. Again, another good drive by Connolly. Didn't get his head up quick enough. The Dock just slowing it down again now. I mean, they were getting easier layups earlier on because we're moving the ball a bit quicker. Rice. For two. Connolly with a great rebound, a great pass out.
Gormley.
Great score from Gormley. Again, uses his body really well to shield the ball. Fabito.
Klosh and the Carver in the lead now. Lovely pass inside.
Great rebound from Abagon. Yeah, he kind of went in a little bit hard in that one.
You'd forgive him a bit of enthusiasm in a final.
Yeah. It can also look bad sometimes when you got a smaller guy going against a bigger guy. You know, he went in, crashed the boards really well. To be fair, number 8 there was Cahill Madden, had got good position. He's going to go to the line there for 2 free throws. This is the first. Rebound. It goes in again, and it's Gormley again. He's done well. 16 seconds now for Dundalk to get a shot away. Ball is stolen eventually.
Gormley gets around the referee there.
Again, he drives to the basket. He's going to the line again for 2 free throws. He's done really well starting the game.
These fouls are costing St. Mary's a lot now in the end of this quarter.
Big time, and that's the third foul as well on Abagon in the first quarter, which is going to be tough on them.
Coach will have to make a decision on him now for the second quarter, you think?
This is the second one. Didn't get it away on time. End of the first. Clash in the Curve 16, St. Mary's Dundalk 12.
Welcome back to this second quarter in the Basketball Ireland School League final in the National Basketball Arena. Kolosnikov has the ball here. Out to Madden. Passes it out. Looking for McWard there. McWard gets another go at it. Just misses again. That man, Akuba, the guy with the rebound.
He stepped out of bounds there. He's unlucky. Ward is trying to get himself involved in the game a lot more. See him with the three and then going inside trying to get a rebound.
That's lovely there.
It's Gormley again. It's a fantastic score. The number 10 is Rice. Rice on the drive. Tough shot, misses it. Rebound taken by Akuba. Tough pass, cross court. Madden kicks it out to Obruda. Madden again attacks the zone. Gormley on the little hook. Gets his own rebound. Working really hard is young Oisin Gormley.
Yeah, he's really stepped it up in the end of the first quarter and the start of the second quarter.
Yeah, like you can see that McWard has a lot of skill and a lot of talent, but Gormley has been superb in the first quarter. I'd say he has about 10, 12 points out of that 18 points his team have, and just seems to be all over the court at the moment, doing really, really well.
Rice brings the ball up the floor there for St. Mary's. Passes out to Pepito. Pepito has a go.
Great rebound again from Akuba. Luke Markey for three. Brings it back to a three-point game. 18-15. For Kolosnikova. Great score from Luke Markey. Pepito with the steal. Drives to the basket. He's going to go to the line again. And kids are making good decisions. They're taking the shots when they're open. They're driving hard to the basket and trying to make the referees make a call, which they're doing. And they go to the line and get their free throws. Now they've got to make their free throws.
Gets the first one. Narrows the gap to two. Let's see if he can make it a one-point game. Unlucky. Good rebounding in there. Just steps out of bounds.
Akuba's been super on the boards. He's just stepped out of bounds a couple of times on his rebounds. Doing really, really well on the glass. You got a substitution coming in. Madden steps out. And number nine, Oisin Turley, checks into the game for the first time. Gormley. That's a great move from Ward, and he picks up the foul. He's going to go to the line for two free throws. That's what Ward has to do to get himself in the game. He has to drive to the basket, get a couple of scores, get a bit of confidence up, and hopefully then he'll be able to make those outside shots he's been given so far. Misses Boat.
If you're disappointed with that, I'd say. Rice brings the ball up. Good steal in there by Gormley. It's great energy, that kid.
Another good drive, just unlucky with the finish. Akuba again with the rebound.
Turley with the ball. Passes to Pepito. Very comfortable on the ball for Pepito.
Yeah, great vision as well. Good pass, good block from McWard out to Gormley. He's going to go at him again. Great
lovely
body position, great finish from Gormley. Nice pass out from McWard there.
Kolosnikov had the lead now, 20 points to 16 with 5 minutes left in the second quarter.
Luke Markey coming off the screen, drives to the basket. Nice little step. He's going to go to the line for two free throws. Ross Nolan coming into the game. Checking in for Connor Obrueda. Oh, nice shot from Luke Markey. This is a second rebound by Rice. Rice makes the bucket, puts it a one-point game, 20 points to 19 in favor of Kolosinacharova. 4:48 to go in the second quarter. Foul this time is called on Akuba. He's going to send McWar to the line. And he's got to make his free throws, JP.
Sure does. Free throws wins the games.
Been there this year.
There we go.
Just needs a couple of easy scores to get his get himself settled. Makes there the second.
Go. Just needs to settle back into the game, McWard.
Rice looks for Akuba. Akuba did well. But he stepped out of bounds again. McWard. Gormley back out to McWard. Open three. Misses it.
Conley.
Stevens.
Managed to win the back. No.
Stevens did well there. Got on the loose ball. Fabito, Stevens, Akuba.
Has the shot.
A tough shot from Akuba. I don't think that's his range. You want to be stepping into the basket a little bit more. Great hands there from number 10. That's Thomas Rice. Stop with Gormley getting another basket. Fabito with a good little tip. Sideline ball.
Good. Turley gets the ball there back to Gormley.
24 second shot clock violation. Going to be a St. Mary's Dundalk ball with their point guard Fabito. Great. Lovely. Pass inside. Again, Thomas Rice, yeah, great backdoor pass. Gormley looking out to McWard.
Goes and drives to the basket there.
Good drive.
Traveled, unfortunately.
Took an extra step. Referee Indrek Ahm makes the call.
Fabito with the ball there for St. Mary's.
He's got to be careful on that screen. Markey. Unlucky with the shot.
Gormley comes away with it again.
That's good ball movement. Swings the ball right around the floor.
Conley with the ball now. Has that to Nolan. Back to Conley.
Little scoop layup. Rebound. Looks down the floor to Stevens. Markey. Nice drive. Great finish, Luke Markey. Luke Markey stepped into the game really, really well. Got 10 points now for St. Mary's Dundalk as they take the lead back 23-22. That's much better. Much better from McWard as he goes to the basket. We could be talking about lead changes here for a while, but it looks at things, JP.
Yeah, it's a bit of to and fro. you can't help but looking at the foul count out by St. Mary's, so that could be
yeah, as the game goes on, they're missing Abogun already. As Stevens comes up with a steal, dribbles it off his foot, manages to keep it in bounds. Connolly to McWard.
Out to Gormley. He thinks about it a lot.
He'll long think about that one.
Capito with the intercept.
Missed the layup. Looking for someone to pass to, and Akuba gives them the outlet. That's McWard, round, nice around the back. Akuba with the steal. Going to go strong at Connolly. That's much better from Akuba. That's what he needs to do, go strong to the basket. Use that big frame he has. Great layup on his left hand.
We haven't seen that much from Akuba in terms of attacking the basket.
No, he set a lot of screens. He seems to be fulfilling his role pretty well, but that was a great score from him. And unlucky for McWard at the other end. Great rebound. As Gormley comes up with another basket.
About 30 seconds left in the first half. There's only 1 point in it.
A little Euro step there from Mark. He was unlucky. Madden's going to check in. And out goes Ross Nolan. Seconds to go. 26-25 in favor of Klosh and Akaraba.
Gormley with the ball again. Out to McWard. Out to Madden. Madden passes inside to Gormley.
Great pass from Gormley.
Lovely out to Connolly.
Got him off his feet. Did really well, McWard. Yeah, great job by McWard. He got Akuba off his feet. And that's going to be Akuba's third foul as well. Makes the basket, goes to the line for a free throw.
Only 11 seconds left in the first quarter, or second quarter.
McWard makes the bonus. Thomas Rice. Steven sets the screen. Fabito wants to get that shot away. Markey's going to get it away. Will he make the three? A little bit big.
That's the end of the first half. It's 29 points to Klosh and Akarab, 25 points to St. Mary's. Welcome back for the third quarter of the Basketball Ireland Schools League final between Cloche and the Carib and St. Mary's Drogheda. I'm here with Martin Conroy from ITC Basketball.
How we doing? Great game so far, 29-25, high scoring in 8 minute quarters. That was Thomas Rice with a 3-point shot.
For me. Lovely pass out there to Madden. Formerly with the shot, just misses. Fabito clears it up.
Royce as well. Feeds Markey, who drives to the basket, pulls up for the shot.
That's unlucky.
Again, it's Mac Ward with the rebound. Hasn't been firing on offense today, but he's done his job on the boards for Cloche and Nicarava.
Conley has a 3-point attempt, and he gets it.
Long two there from the referee, called him two. Looked like a three to me as well. Fabito. Markey for three. Conley with the rebound this time.
Madden with the ball to Gormley. So overshoots the wrong way with the pass to McAdam. Or to McWard, sorry.
Markey again for three. Unlucky, rims hits the front of the rim. Ward misses it. Comes out to Connolly for three this time. Stevens with the rebound.
Nice stuff there.
Kuba, yeah, he did travel. Kuba was a great pass from Rice. See, Gormley now has stepped up the floor a little bit on his defense on Fabito, trying to take their playmaker out of the game a little bit. Nice pass from Mac Ward. Again, Akuba on the rebound. Fabito trying to get his offense set. Long two again, rebound again from Mac Ward. Another great outlet pass to Gormley. He's going to drive on him. Reverses Lovely. The layup. Great finish from Gormley.
Cloche and Carib extend their lead to 8 points now.
That's the biggest lead of the game for Cloche and Carib. Fabito with the long two. And makes it.
Conley with the shot, just misses. McWard gets the rebound though. What's he going to do with it?
Yeah, foul called on number 10, Thomas Rice. Is going to send Ward, Mac Ward, to the line for two shots. We get the substitutions coming in. Connolly takes a breather with number 10, Ross Nolan, coming in. And Stevens is going to sit out, and we got Abagon coming back on. Misses the first. And misses the second. Abagon with the rebound straight off the bench. Fabito, what a pass to Akuba, misses it. Abagon with the rebound, gives it to Fabito. Nice finish. All of a sudden, we're back to 4 points. Nice fake and drive by Gormley.
Unlucky. Rebound in there from Rice.
He's definitely been the focal point of their offense so far, JP.
He sure is.
Rice with the ball.
He thinks about driving inside, but he passes it out.
Fabito for three. Misses the shot. And Madden comes up with the rebound. Defense!
Formerly with the ball. Passes out to Madden. He's under a lot of pressure there.
You just see Gormley when he received that pass. He's not even looking to shoot the ball. He's just looking to pass. It makes it so much easier for that zone defense. Well, Bruda comes back in for number 9, Oisin Turley.
Gormley has a shot. He makes it.
Much better from Gormley. Great shot. Fabito off the hesitation. Unlucky on the finish.
McWard drives to the basket.
Great block from Markey there. Akuba was lucky to far side. He could have picked up his fourth foul very easily.
Price has a go.
Yeah, great rebound from Akuba. Gives it inside to Rice. Here's your layup. Timeout is called by Kolosinacharva. 3:17 to go in the third. 35-31 in favor of Kolosinacharva.
There are 3 minutes left in the third quarter. The score is Kolosinacharva 35, St. Mary's Drogheda 31.
They've come out of their zone for the first time. They've gone man. Straight away the drive comes in from Kolosinacharva. Favito to Rice. Misses the three. Whoops.
Oh.
That's Ross Nolan getting a little bit upset with himself. He was unlucky there. He got in the air and wasn't able to control the ball. Got called for a travel. Big man drives to the basket. That was Abagon. Oh, there is his fourth foul as well on Akuba.
Could be getting a bit of a rest here, Martin.
Yeah, like... I don't think coach has just looked up at the scoreboard to see it. I'd be taking him out there very quickly if I was him. He's the kind of kid you're going to do with down the stretch as Gormley drives and is missed. Great rebound by Rice. Madden fouls him at the half court. Stephen McShane has taken a bit of a risk by leaving Akuba in there at the minute with his four fouls.
They're racking them up, all right. Akuba on four.
12 fouls to five. As Abagon misses the shot. Gormley pulls up for two.
Oh, doesn't get the roll, unfortunately.
Still a tight game, could go any way, JP.
Sure could. It's getting tense. You can almost feel it in the air.
Rice, long two, misses it. Great rebound from Abagon. Markey comes off the screen. Spin dribble to the middle. Great job by Luke Markey. He's gonna go to the line for two free throws. You know, down the stretch, I think, you know, Abagon and Akuba are gonna be huge for Dundalk, so they don't want to be picking up any more fouls. Substitution coming in for...
It's Turley coming in for Nolan, I think.
Yeah, it is indeed. Markey on the line. Makes the first. Yeah, I see his dad across from us there, giving a big clap for him. This is the second. The rebound is going to come to Abagan, to Kuba. Didn't see Vivito wide open on the other side. Comes out to Rice. Great drive by Rice. Thomas Rice, 2 points. 1 point game, 35-34, 1:37 to go in the third quarter.
Turley passes the ball inside. Now Gormley has a go.
Great pass again. Markey goes strong to the basket. Looks to pick the foul. It's not called. McAdams out to Madden for two. Five-point game. Great steal from Gormley. Akuba can't foul, and Gormley scores. He's been unbelievable, JP.
He's a great energy all day, been up and down, getting points.
He's got about 20 of those 41 points from his team. As Markey with a long three misses, and McWard feeds out to Gormley again. Again, uses his body excellently. Great rebound from Vito. It's going to be a jump ball. It's going to be Klosh and a curve ball. All of a sudden, it's a 7-point game. Shot goes up and is missed. Passed out to Rice. Madden does really well to steal it away.
13 seconds left on the clock. Gormley has the ball.
He's looking for a little screen to come from. Good pass to Connolly. Is he going to get it? No. Referee says it's baseline ball. 2.5 seconds to go. 41-34. Kalashnikarva. Dundalk could do with getting a stop here, JP. It's too easy for Connolly. Misses the shot. Rebound's taken. End of the third. 41-34 in favor of Kalashnikarva.
Back in the National Basketball Arena for the fourth quarter of this Basketball Ireland Schools League final between Cloister na Cairb and St. Mary's Dundalk. Score is 41 points to Cloister na Cairb and 34 points to St. Mary's, so 7-point game. It's going to be interesting.
Great drive by Luke Markey there. Madden, Gormley.
Back to Madden. It's McWard. Here's the shot.
Yeah, he met his first three and hasn't hit one since then, unfortunately. But he's done his job on the boards. Been really, really tough on the boards for Kolashnikov. Fabito. Good score coming in from Abagan. With Abagan and the Kuban, four fouls each. They got to stay in the game for as long as they can now for their team. Great steal by Luke Markey. Thomas Rice. Rice again driving. Ball is straight out of bounds. Kolashnikov ball.
Madden with the ball. Passes it all the way out to Connolly. That man Gormley has it now. To Madden. Doesn't get the bank.
Ooh, nice spin out of trouble there from McWard. He gets it back, top of the key. Steps in, looks to bank it, doesn't happen. Gormley, great fake. Great check by Luke Markey. It's going to be a possession for Kolashnikov. Don't think this game is over just yet, JP.
Far from it. Far from it. Lovely pass out there. Another one to Conley.
Can't foul him. And it's Kuba with the rebound. Fabito. Dribbled it off his teammate's foot. Gives an easy possession back to Kolashnikov.
Gormley has the ball now. Can drive to the basket, is he?
Kicks it to Madden. Kicks outside. McWard for three and misses it. Rebound. A great just rebound from Markey. Thomas Rice. Open shot. Misses it. Rebound from Markey again. Tough shot. Going to be a jump ball. This one's going to be Kolashnikov.
I'm surprised the Kolashnikov boys aren't driving more for the basket in this last quarter to try and get some of these lads in foul trouble on the bench.
Yeah, you'd imagine they would do that, especially would have been, you know, the two best rebounders probably for St. Mary's in Akuba and Abagan. They should be going at them, and here we go. There goes Gormley. They've got to be very disciplined to make sure that they stay on the floor, which is the other side as well. Markey sees a hole. Comes back out to Fabito. Rice. Markey again.
To Rice.
Rice, he's got 5 seconds to shoot. A steal by Gormley. There's my man again. Gormley with another two. He really attacks the basket very well. Great steal by Madden at half court. Misses the layup, and Fabito comes up with a rebound. Ah, nice step, nice layup. Coach from Kolashnikov was looking for a travel there, but it definitely wasn't a travel. It was a good score.
Conley with the shot. He gets this.
There's his big three. Stretches his team's lead out to 8 points. Equals the largest lead of the game.
He's had a couple of big points in the last couple of quarters, Conley, in fairness to him.
Yeah, he's played well. Just too static from Dundalk at the moment. Pass goes out to Madden. Can he save it? No,
much.
He tries to hit someone in the crowd with it. He knows he was wrong. He's coming over to apologize. If he does it again, he's going to get teed up.
Eyes of the ball. Eta Abigan. Balls with Fepito. Out to rights again. Markey with the ball now.
That's a great job from Markey. It's a great score. They're settling for shots now. They're not driving to the basket like they were in the first half. They're settling for those outside shots and hoping they can get a rebound, and it's not really working for them at the moment. There's Gormley with a superb pass to Mac Ward for two. Abigan. Bit tough off the glass and a rebound by Mac Ward again. Gormley out on the break. Akubu.
Abigan. It's out to Akubu. Good rebounding in there by Conley again.
Yeah, he's done well in this quarter. Madden with the shot. And again, it's Akubu with the rebound. Ball goes out of bounds. It's going to be St. Mary's Dundalk ball. Foul is called on Connolly. It's going to send Akubu to the free throw line for two free throws. 1:46 to go. 48-40 in favor of Kloshnikarov. This is the first. This is the second. Tipped out there by Abigan. Timeout is called. 1:44 to go. 48-40 in favor of Kloshnikarov.
So we've 1 minute, 44 seconds left in the fourth quarter. There's 8 points in it. Kloshnikarov have the lead.
Pressure's been wrapped up a little bit by St. Mary's. Gormley still able to get a nice pass, but you got a travel violation called on Madden. Still time for Dundalk, if they believe.
8 points in 1.5 minutes is no bother to these lads, I wouldn't have thought, but you have to do it.
Markey, unlucky with a shot.
Well done. Great rebounding there by McWard. Lovely pass to Gormley as well.
He likes that little show and go. Makes a basket for his team, stretches the lead out to 10 points. Great drive by Rice. Drove into the contact. Going to be end line ball for Kloshnikarov as the full court press comes on. Madden. Gormley. Just running out the clock now, and no real pressure coming from St. Mary's Dundalk. Gormley kicks it out.
Turley just misses. Pepito. Bit of urgency there from him.
Great try, but it's got to be urgency on the defense as well, and it's not happening. They're stepping back up.
Gormley has the ball. It's three, man.
Gonna slow it down, bring it out. No need for them even to shoot the ball at this stage. Just got to keep it, run down the clock. No pressure coming on at all from St. Mary's. Going to pull up for three. Unlucky from Rice. Jump ball. This one's going to be a blue ball for St. Mary's. 17.2 to go. Markey, Fabito, tries the floater, doesn't make it.
Eight seconds left, 8-point game.
And timeout called by St. Mary's Dundalk. Eight point 6 seconds to go, and it's an 8-point game in favor of Kolosinacharov.
So 8 seconds left on the clock. Kolosinacharov with an 8-point lead. Kolosinacharov has the ball now. They're just going to run out the clock, you think?
Just get it over half court. Got to get it over half court because it was 8.2. There it is, and there's the game.
Well done, Kolosinacharov, the under 16 B Boys Schools League winners. And well done also to the lads from Dundalk, St. Mary's. They played very well with some great plays there, particularly for Pito, who's a great player.
Yeah, Fapido and young Markey played really, really well. They got in a bit of foul trouble earlier on with Akubu and Abagon. But like Kolosinacharov were definitely the better outfit on the day. McWard played really well. Madden played well. Connolly did a lot in the fourth quarter. And of course, young Gormley played really, really well as well. So, fit and win for them. They did really, really well. 50 points in an 8-minute quarter game is pretty impressive as well. So, well done to Kolosinacharov. I think that's the double done for them, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, I believe so.
So, well done to them, and I leave you with JP now for the presentation.
Now,